Hive tyrants are the leaders of the Tyranid swarms and the creatures through which the hive mind is able to dominate the lesser creatures. And in this video, we're going to show you how to paint one in the colours of Hive Fleet Leviathan using the classic method, and we'll paint it up to battle ready. To do this, the undercoat colour you should use is Wraithbone, and you can see this is what I've sprayed my miniature with just here. Now you can of course paint it Wraithbone by hand instead if you want to, and if you choose to do so, just make sure it's completely covered with this paint before you start adding anything else, but you'll find you get a much smoother finish with the spray paint, which is really useful for the skin, so we do recommend you use that. Either way, it's a good idea to have a pot of Wraithbone on hand just in case you need to neaten up. The first base paint we need to apply though is Naggaroth Knight, and this is for the carapace, and I'm going to be applying this mostly using a medium base brush, but you might want to have a large base brush on hand for some of the larger areas of detail, in particular the carapace on the back of the miniature. But throughout this process, what you should do is just get some paint onto your palette like that, then add a touch of water to thin it down so it's nice and smooth. There we go, so it's running really smoothly from your brush, and then all you need to do is start painting this onto the armoured segments on the back of the miniature. So for example, I'm talking about the armour such as just along here. Now as you apply this, you'll find it is quite transparent and you can see a lot of that Wraithbone very easily through it, particularly on larger areas such as just up here. Don't worry about that, it's just because you're going from a very light colour to a very dark colour. All you need to do is apply it like this, allow it to dry, and then apply a second thin coat in the exact same way to ensure you get a nice even finish before you move on to the next colour. Once you've finished picking out all those purple details, you're then ready to move on to the remaining base colours of the miniature. And what we need first of all for this is corn red for all the red parts, and then we're going to move on to some Bugman's Glow for all the fleshy parts, followed by a very small amount of Avalan Sunset. Now first of all we need corn red, and I'm going to be using my medium base brush once again here, and this is going to be for some smaller details than what we did with the purple, but the same technique is what we need here. So again, use the palette to just thin the paint down with just a tiny bit of water. There we go, and when you're ready, the areas you're now looking for are the claws, also the sword, and also the main body of the cannon that we've got here. So I want to paint in this kind of area like this. As for the claws, it's much smaller areas, it's areas such as around here. And as before, just apply two thin coats to ensure you get nice even coverage before you move on. Next, we're ready to add some Bugman's Glow, applied using a medium layer brush. And this is for areas such as fleshy tubes, for example, just around here. Also, we need to make sure we base coat in the tongue at this stage along here. And we also need to base coat the main body of the whip. And finally, base coat all the eyes using Avalan Sunset. Now, of course, there are eyes on the head, such as just in there, but there are eyes on the weapons as well, so be sure not to miss those. For example, we've got one just down here. And with those eyes now painted, we've finished applying all the base paints to the miniature, and we can move on to adding the shade paints to it. Now the first one we're going to be using is some Caraberg Crimson to give that sort of pinkish tinge to the skin, but we don't want to do this straight out the pot because this colour is quite strong, and if we do so we'll actually turn the skin fully pink, and we just want that little hint of it, remember. So what we're going to do is dilute it using Lamia Medium, which will allow us to take away the strength of the colour without changing the properties of the paint. So I'm going to start out by making that mix, and what I'm going to do is do it using a medium shade brush, and I'll start out with some Caraberg Crimson so you can see what I'm doing. Just get a little bit of that onto my palette there like that, and make sure the brush is clean before you get any of the medium. And what I'm going to roughly do here is get to about three parts of Lamia Medium to one part of Caraberg Crimson. Doesn't have to be exact, but if in doubt, add more medium than you think you're going to need. So one, two, and three. There we go, mix those together so you see I've got a very subtle diluted version of the colour. And once you've done this, all you need to do is start painting this onto all the flesh. So primarily we're looking at the white areas here, for example on the side of the head. I'm just going to let it run into the recessed detail like that, just to give that little pinkish hue to it. Whilst you're doing this, you want to try and avoid the teeth as best you can. If you do catch them, just neaten up afterwards. But as you paint it on, just be sure to catch all the flesh coloured areas, so this for example, and also the red areas as well. Once you've finished applying this on these areas, give the miniature about an hour to dry. The mix is now completely dry, and you can see, especially on the pale areas of the body, it's really added depth and brought out all the detail of the miniature. But what we need to do now is just carry on adding a few more shades to the model by starting out by returning to Caraberg Crimson to make some parts a little bit redder. Then we're going to move on to Agrax Earth Shade to give the teeth a slightly different colour from the skin, and then some Druki Violet to shade all the carapace details. Finally, we just need a very small amount of Reichland Flesh Shade in some specific areas. But first of all, we're going to return to Caraberg Crimson, and I'm going to be applying it mostly with a medium layer brush this time, but it's a good idea to have a small layer brush on hand for some of the finer details. But what we need to do is use the palette here just to help control how much of this we're applying at once. Don't need to thin it down at all this time, but use the palette just to get rid of excess paint and to bring the bristles together. And what we're going to do is to paint this into certain detailed areas where we want the features to be a bit redder. For example, the joints that you can see amongst the limbs, just here on the arm, what we're going to do is just run it into that area like that to make it a bit more pink. there like that. Now also you get these kind of strange vent-like designs on the side of the limbs too, and we need to run it into these. For example, we've got one just on here in the arm. All you do is just run it into that recessed area there like that. Finally, the red details in the miniature, we want to add a bit more of this colour to make them a little bit darker. For example, the sword and the cannon here, all you need to do is just paint the shade undiluted this time all over these areas. With that done, we're now going to add a little bit of Agrax shade to the teeth to give them a different tone from the rest of the flesh. And for this, apply it using a small layer brush. Now that the teeth are done, we can move on to shading the carapace. And for this, we need Druki Violet applied mostly with a medium shade brush, but have a medium layer brush on hand for the smaller details. And finally, we can add some Reichlin Flesh Shade to the miniature, painted onto all the details that we previously base coated using Bugman's Glow. And with that, all the shade paints have been applied, and all we need to do now is add some texture to the base of the miniature. And for this, we're going to use Sterling Mud. Now, to apply this kind of paint, what you need is one of these texture tools, and to apply it, what you do is just get a good scoop of the paint on the shovel side like this, and then look for an open space on the base. And for this miniature, there's quite a lot of space. All you do is put the paint on like that, and then start moving it around, going right up to the feet of the miniature. Now, this paint will take quite a bit of time to dry, around about an hour, but make sure it's completely dry before you move on to the next step, which is to paint the rim of the base. And this can be any colour you like, but for this miniature, I'm going to use Steel Legion Drab. And there we are, with the base now fully painted, this Hive Tyrant is ready for battle. So when you're painting a miniature like this, there's a real key important thing to remember, and that is when you're applying those base paints to it, in particular Naggaroth Knight and Khorne Red, you'll find at first they look quite patchy because you're going from a very extreme light undercoat to very dark colours. Don't worry about this, all you need to do is apply multiple thin coats to the paint to ensure you get a nice smooth even finish to it. Remember, multiple thin coats are always better than one thick coat. But really that's the most important thing you need to remember. So we really hope you have fun painting your Hive Tyrant, and we'll see you all again very soon.